First thing I did was clean up my room. Hung up all the t-shirts on the floor. Put my socks, underwear, and two t-shirts in a pile by the door. Made my bed. Sheets, good and tight. Not a wrinkle in the spread. Looked at all my posters. Stopped seeing them. Rubbed my autographed baseball. Went out into the hall. Stopped. Went back and grabbed the pile of clothes by the door. Took them to the bathroom and dropped them in the hamper. Went into my brother's bedroom. Came out of that empty room into all the other empty rooms upstairs. No one home in the kitchen or the rest of the house. There were some dirty glasses in the kitchen sink and three plates with egg stains. I scrubbed them all clean and laid them in the dish rack to dry. I tried to look out the kitchen window, but there was too much light. I opened the cellar door before I opened the cellar door. I mean, I could see myself doing it. I walked down the stairs. It was like my mind was going into darkness. Water. Bob. My mind had nothing to do with it anymore. I could see the axe on the wall. The hammer. The saw. I found a piece of rope by the washing machine. I got up on a box and tied it to a pipe. And then I tied it around my neck. I tried to look out the window, see if there was anyone in the street, but I couldn't see any legs. I kept one leg on the box and lowered the other into the free air. I don't remember kicking over the box, but they tell me I did. My brother said he felt something strange when he came into the house. If he hadn't found me when he did, I'd be a vegetable. Or dead. So, I'm glad he cut me down. And although it's a little embarrassing to tell you all this, I'm really glad I can't.